Hello, I'm Sandhya and I do easy and quick Indian recipes on this channel. Today's recipe is a snack from the state of Uttarakhand called Badil. This can be made out of Masoor Dal, which has the skin on, or Chana Dal. The ingredients list is given in the description box below. Before we move on to the video, if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please consider subscribing by clicking the subscribe button and the bell next to it for notification. If you like the video, don't forget to like, share and comment. Let's have a look at the ingredients required for the badil. So we are going to use Masoor Dal, the one with the skin on. So I've got the whole Masoor Dal, which I've soaked overnight and drained and kept ready. We need some chopped coriander leaves. This is a mixture of garlic, ginger and green chili. I've made a paste out of it. You need coriander powder, red chili powder, salt to taste, garam masala powder and turmeric powder. I also have some finely chopped onion. And we'll need oil also to make this dish. So let's start making the dish. So the first step is to make a rough paste out of the Masoor Dal in the mixer. So I'll just make the paste and come back. So I've made a rough paste out of the Masoor Dal and it's like this. Add little water to make a paste. So the paste is ready. Now let's move on to cook the badil. So I've got a kadai in which I've got some oil heating up. Into the oil will go the onions. These are finely chopped onions. And we cook the onion as we are soft. Once the onion softens, we'll add all the spice powders and the salt to taste. Coriander powder, red chili powder, garam masala, turmeric, and salt to taste. Mix everything together. We allow the masalas to cook for a minute. We'll add in the ginger, garlic and green chili paste. Cook the ginger, garlic and green chilies until the raw smell disappears. Now, let's add in the Masoor Dal paste. Mix the dal with the rest of the spices. Now we'll cook this dal until it leaves the sides of the pan and the oil separates. That's going to take a few minutes. Into this we'll also add some coriander leaves. And make sure you mix it well. You can see that it's coming together, almost like a halwa. We'll mix it further so that it starts leaving the bottom of the pan. So now you can see it's left the sides of the pan and become almost like a halwa. Now it's time to switch off the fire and remove it from the kadai. I've got a plate in here which I've applied some oil to, just to grease the bottom. So that's ready here. I'm going to transfer the contents into this plate. Now quickly we'll shape it into a square. It's a little hot, so be careful. Make sure it's of the same thickness all around. So this is ready. Let's just let it cool a little. You can put it in the refrigerator to cool. So the mixture has cooled down nicely in the refrigerator and I have removed it now. Now let's cut this into diamond shapes. So we've cut it into diamond shapes. Now let's move on to the next process. I've got oil heating up in a kadai. Into this, we'll drop the badil diamonds one by one. We'll fry them until they are golden brown in color. Do not flip them immediately because they tend to break. Just give it a few moments before you flip them. Once it's golden brown, you can remove it into a plate. So badil is ready. You can serve this with some hara chutney or coriander chutney. You can enjoy it as a snack or as a mid-meal. I hope you liked today's recipe. If you did, please do try it at home and let me know in the comment section. Until I see you next time, bye-bye.